fans can feel anxiety at one time or another. How you can tell the difference if you are a fan or if you are a fanatic when it comes to anxiety levels. This is a good topic here. 7:42, you're watching Fox 45 Morning News, all local, all morning.
7:44 right now in the morning. 10 seconds. New Orleans went up by one. The throw, the leaping catch. Saints back Marcus Williams misses the tackle. Vikings receiver Stephon Diggs take it another 40 yards the end zone before ripping his helmet off with a walk-off win, dubbed the Minnesota Miracle. Emotional roller coaster as heart monitors strapped to fans' wrists around the globe start sounding alarms. Here now to discuss the difference between being a fan and a fanatic, Shmuel Fischler with CBT Baltimore. That's the play right there that we're talking about. And you had even told me, you said, you know what? There's stories about heart monitors that are going off for eye watches that we're telling people, watch out, you may have a heart attack.
Yeah. There's the smartwatches were going off and say, you might be having a heart attack right now based on your heart rate. So it's pretty intense. Pretty intense moment. It's emotional and physical.
Right. Well, now, the thing about this is, though, and this started lots of discussions around here, you can be a fan, but then there is a line where you turn into a fanatic, and that's when it becomes unhealthy. What are some of the ways that you would list somebody as either a fan or a fanatic?
All right, so I have to say, listen, I'm also a major sports fan, lifelong Cubs fan. I've been with the ups and downs, so I can certainly...
A lot of downs with Cubs. Okay.
Well, we've made it. We're over that now. There's certainly a difference between a healthy relationship with sports and an unhealthy relationship with sports. You know, it really boils down to two questions, I would say, is what draws us to it? And is it really singular focus? Like, is sports the only thing going on in your life? It's the end-all and be-all, and you have nothing else going on? And how we react to it.
Okay.
You know, how long does it take for us to get over a win, or I mean, not get over a win, but get over a loss, you know.
I was telling you this, growing up in Philadelphia, I could walk into the house at night and see if the Phillies won or lost just by my dad's expression. You know, he would just be depressed if they lost, especially in the late 80s, I mean, after winning it. But other days, you know, he's fine. And he let that kind of affect him for a few days, it seemed like, but then he would slough it off.
And there's actually science behind it. There's the concept of something called mirror neurons, where when we're watching something, whether it be like an intense movie or an intense game, such as, you know, the Vikings game.
Right.
There's neurons firing in our brain that it's almost as if we are experiencing what we're watching, as if we're on the field even though we're not. Okay. So our bodies are almost having that same reaction. I have a friend who's a huge Vikings fan.
Right.
I saw him 24 hours later, and he almost felt like physically ill. Even though they won, he's happy, but he still felt it on his body because he was that roller coaster of emotions. He still felt it.
How do you talk somebody off the emotional ledge, if you will, when there's a win or a loss like that that's so dependent on it? I mean, because it's a great time, Super Bowl. Families get together, friends get together. You want to share those uplifting moments together, but then the losses also really can bring people down. A lot of alcohol then ties in with that.
Yeah. That's, you know, if someone is really susceptible to that, I would try to lay off some of that alcohol. Good. But clinically speaking, if someone like came in and wanted and really had an issue with this, I would really be curious about what kind of thoughts they have associated or beliefs they have with sports. Like, is sports my religion? Do I really feel like I'm an extension of the team? A lot of people like will use that, like, it's my team, it's me. And question, like, is it really you? It's not, you know, there's more to your life than your team.
State of dependency, then.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, sure.
Shmuel Fischler with CBT Baltimore, thank you so much. We appreciate your time
coming
in.
Me.